Hey everyone, and welcome to another After Effects tutorial. My name is Tyler Bradway, and this is Creativid Studios. Today, I'm going to show you how to make another hyperdrive space jump effect in After Effects. Okay, so let's just jump right into it. Making a new composition, 1920 by 1080. We'll name it Final Comp. And we'll make a solid that is white and 1920 by 1920. Hit OK. Now we'll add Starburst. Now this effect kind of looks like crap. So let's try to make it look better. So first off, there's too many stars. So we'll reduce the amount of stars by increasing the spacing to like 15. But now the stars are too big, so we reduce it to 20 for the size, and maybe decrease the scatter so there's a little bit more. But still, this effect, when the stars get close to the camera, they like disappear. And we don't want that. We want the stars to go all the way past the camera. So to do this, we're gonna use polar coordinates. So let's just put that on and stretch it out to make this into a rectangular map. So if we shut off the starburst, let's look at what it did. So it takes it and it kind of stretches it, but it makes these holes in it. So we'll just move down our layer a little bit and turn starburst back on. And this is what it did. Pretty cool, right? So, now let's pre-compose this. Name it Stars Moving. Next, we're gonna add CC Cylinder to this, and it's gonna essentially wrap the map into a cylinder shape. So let's decrease the radius to 5 and it disappears, but it's actually just really small. If you zoom in, you can see it. Now we gotta position our camera so that we're inside of the tube. So let's do rotation minus 90 and position, I already know these values because I tried it before. Position, we do 2000. Wait, was it 2000 or minus 2000? Minus 2000. So now we have this, which is almost what we want. Now, well, I mean, that is basically what we want. Let's come into shading and just turn the ambience to 100% so that it doesn't have shading. Let's try to make a transition into hyperspace and a transition out of hyperspace, okay? So to do that, we're gonna go back into this layer, hit Command C with this layer selected, and Command V back in this composition, and we're gonna delete polar coordinates on this one. And let's just move this layer over to like 1 second. Let's just reposition it to the center, 960 by 540. And we have this, but we don't want it to be moving yet. So let's do Command Shift C to precompose, or you could right click and hit precompose. And we'll do, make sure you move the attributes because we need the starburst in the precomp. Name it beginning and ending. Okay, so it's still moving, obviously. So we have to do time, freeze frame. So now we get this. So we want it to transition from this to this. So I just trimmed the back end of that, and we'll add a optics compensation. Let's overlap it a little bit so we can see what we're doing. Field of view, let's put a keyframe and make sure to click reverse lens distortion So let's take a look. Okay, so now these new stars are about the same length as the old stars. And then we go to the beginning and just put it to zero. And I think that can come in a little faster, so I'm gonna hit U on my keyboard and just move the keyframe in. To make it a better transition, let's just hit T to open opacity and make a keyframe and then come over to this frame, maybe make it like 50. So now say we want it to end here. So we'll Command Shift D to split it, hit delete on that second part, and then we'll duplicate this, bring it over, we'll delete these keyframes and delete this keyframe too. So now we're gonna want to make sure the lens distortion is not, the reverse lens distortion is not checked. So let's uncheck that and go to about like right here. Set a keyframe for zero. And then, oh, you can't see it. And then make another one. Right there. Now we can extend this a little bit and T on this bottom layer, the zooming layer, and make a transition. So we'll just do that. Maybe put this layer below here. It's gonna take some finessing. So that's basically it for this tutorial. I had to finesse these keyframes a little bit, but it's still not perfect. But for the purposes of the tutorial, I think you get the gist. Yeah, so that's it for this tutorial, guys. Hit that like button, it helps me out. Yeah, so I'll see you guys next time.